In this video lesson, we're going to go ahead and look at how to fix one of the most common issues in 3D animation, overshoot. Overshoot is when the motion of the camera goes into an unintended area. And this overshoot will be seen if you're animating the camera using fixed transitions. Fixed transitions create a smooth curve for the camera to travel along. We provide several keyframes to create the path of the camera. The computer creates the in-between frames or points between our keyframes. This is called interpolation. The trick is understanding and controlling the interpolation between the keyframes. Let's look at how overshoot happens. Let's create three keyframes and navigate from above San Francisco down into the city and lastly down a street. Seems simple enough, right? Let's try to do this with three keyframes. The first keyframe is set from above. Now we move the camera forward and set the second keyframe at the start of the street. And lastly, we set the third keyframe down further into the street. Now let's change the duration so it's a bit longer. Remember, whenever I set a pen keyframe in the ribbon, it adheres to the value in a pen time. By default, this is at 3 seconds. So let's set the duration to 12 seconds and play the animation back. Wow, that's unexpected. I never set any keyframes going through the buildings. And that's part of the problem. By not giving the computer enough keyframes to calculate an accurate path, we get an unexpected path between our limited keyframes. Specifically, when one transition covering a long distance sits next to another transition covering a short distance, you often get unwanted overshoot. Let's look at this by turning on the display path. So here you see, look at the spacing between our keyframes. Between keyframes 1 and 2, we travel almost 5 times the distance that we travel between keyframe 2 and 3. So to fix this, we need to create an additional key between keyframe 2 and 3. This is what we call an in-between. This extra key will inform the computer on how to interpolate between key 2 and 3. So let's type 2.25 into the key list editor. By doing this, we will move the camera 1/4 the distance, or 25%, between keyframe 2 and 3. Next, we're going to update the view into the correct position. Now we use the update button in the ribbon to store this value as a new keyframe. This will become the new keyframe 3. Let's play it back to see what we get. We still have a bit of overshoot, but it's almost fixed. Now let's adjust keyframe 2 to alleviate the final bit of overshoot. Zoom to keyframe 2 and reposition the camera back a bit. Now update keyframe 2 with this new position. When I play the animation back, you will see that we've accounted for the overshoot by adjusting keyframe 2. So here's the important thing to remember. Never create more keyframes than you have to. To keep the camera path smooth, place only the necessary keys to control the camera. At the beginning of this animation, we had too few keys, and the camera was moving in an unexpected way. But by providing just one more key, we were able to fix the tail end of the animation. So there you have it, fixing overshoot. See you next time and happy animating.